Hi everyone, I'm Allison Crocciola, a student at Duquesne University. I recently went around asking a few professors about the process in which they take in choosing literary texts for students in their classes. I also wanted to hear about their favorite, or rather most influential book that impacted them in some type of way. You'll be hearing from Dr. Matt Ucia, who is an English professor, and he specializes in literary theory and North American literature of the 20th and 21st century. You'll also be hearing from Dr. Thomas Kinahan, who is another English professor, and he specializes in American literature.
What is your process for choosing materials for students to read for your classes?
Well, that depends a lot on the class I'm teaching, so I like to consider the background and preparation of the students. I try to choose things that might be, that would be accessible, but have a little bit of challenge to mm-hmm. them, you know, just to find, sometimes I've used the rubber band analogy. You want something that, you know, will stretch students a little bit, but not overstretch.
Right.
That's how I would approach a course that has students with a mix of interests and backgrounds.
So for me, it is, I guess maybe the best is my 102 example. Mm-hmm. That is the imaginative literature course. So it's a composition course primarily that is also supposed to, you know, expose students to literature. So unlike, say, some of my other colleagues on this hall who, might be teaching a subject-based or period-based, era-based, genre-based course, I actually don't have a lot of the expectations that they have. My biggest approach is just thinking about, well, what can I do that, you know, offers students a diverse set of experiences that might appeal to them? That is my primary question. You know, how do I get something that will appeal to a group of students, the things that they might at least, they'll be challenged by them, but they might find something mm-hmm. interesting or see a piece of their own experience with them. The What Does the World Want From Me?
Yeah.
Which was adapted from a coming of age of literature course, which it almost seemed like it was maybe too broad. And I was like, no, why don't we make the course centered around a question? And then from there, the books, I just thought, okay, so I need drama, I need poetry, I need thing. And so I came from an undergrad English department that was very, very traditional.
Mm-hmm.
And so we basically read white men. We read dead white men, and there was like a day where we read some women.
So now when I think about teaching, a lot of times I try to teach in my American literature courses with a real attention to cultural context, what's going on in the world of art,
right.
Politics, music. Mm-hmm.
Through your career, teaching, learning, going through school, whatever it is,
mm-hmm.
what has stuck out to you, has been influential to you?
Mine would be Henry David Thoreau's Walden,
okay.
which really a lot of people look to as sort of a starting place for American environmentalism and environmental literature. I think the Frederick Douglass, the slave narrative, gives
yeah.
a side of history. It's a fascinating story, and he's also quite a
mm-hmm.
writer. For earlier periods,
yeah.
Ben Franklin's autobiography
okay.
contains a lot of really fundamental sort of American ideals about individualism, work, success, etc.
The reason why they're in the top is I read them at a moment in my life when I almost sort of needed to read them, and that they changed me as a person. Life After God by Douglas Copeland. To the Lighthouse by Virginia Woolf. Can I do a tie for third?
Yeah.
Optimist's Daughter by Eudora Welty. And actually the collection of the short stories of John Cheever.
I had a thought, dear, however scary, about that night, the bugs and the dirt. Why were you? Before those hands pulled me from the earth.
I will not ask you where you came from. I will not ask him, neither should he.